Welcome back to Matter of Fact. We're in Tampa, Florida, where the National League of Cities is hosting its centennial gathering, bringing together mayors from across the country. Clarance Anthony, the former mayor of South Bay, Florida, leads the organization, and he told me about the unique challenges local leaders are facing in this divided time.
What would these leaders say to you are their biggest concerns?
I'll never forget during COVID, leaders calling me crying because they were the ones that people called and expected them to do something, and they couldn't do anything, but there was that expectation. And when I think back on those moments and I think to the present, the one thing that we gotta help them with is dealing with the mental health challenges that we are seeing in our municipal leadership and service. The other thing I'll say is the issue of civility. We're finding through surveying our members that over 80% of them have experienced some form of harassment, and their kids and their partners have been bullied because the discord, the lack of civility. We're here as the National League of Cities to help them through this, and we're gonna do that because they got a lot of work to do, and it's gonna take local leadership to get our country in the direction that we need it to go.
Clarance Anthony, thank you so much. Pleasure.
Thank you for having me.
Still ahead on Matter of Fact, these buildings once housed some of Tampa's 200 cigar factories. We get a look inside the last one still in operation.
Finally, about 3.5 miles from here is the neighborhood of Ybor City. It's known as Cigar City. Tampa's cigar manufacturing started in the late 1800s. It grew to about 200 factories, making Tampa the cigar-producing capital of our nation. Producer Tara Cleary takes us to the J.C. Newman Cigar Company, the last operating cigar factory in the entire country.
My name is Drew Newman, member of the fourth generation of J.C. Newman Cigar Company. My great-grandfather, Julius Caesar Newman, came to America in 1888 in search of the American dream. He arrived with his family, and they settled in Cleveland, Ohio. And for reasons that we don't fully understand, he decided to become a cigar maker. He started at the bottom as an apprentice. And in 1895, he opened his own cigar company, which he called the J.C. Newman Cigar Company. Our company became the largest cigar factory in Cleveland. But then my great-grandfather realized that the future of the cigar industry was in Tampa, Florida. So at the age of 78, my great-grandfather decided to move his family and to move his company from Cleveland to Tampa.
This is 7th Avenue in Ybor City. In 1920s, really the peak of the cigar industry, looked very much like it does today. Without the cigar industry, Tampa would be an entirely different city. The cigar industry had a huge workforce. In 1880, there were 720 people in Tampa. Just 10 years later, in 1890, there were almost 6,000 people here in Tampa.
Hi, Lewis. Hi, Annie.
Unlike any other industry in this country, cigar factory work was actually pretty quiet. But because it was very quiet and a little tedious, a little monotonous, the cigar factory workers actually hired readers to read to them while they were working. And these readers, or lectors, were hired by and paid by the cigar factory workers. The factory owners actually didn't like them very much because they read some pretty radical stuff.
All of Tampa cigar factories in the 1880s and early 1900s rolled hundreds of millions of cigars every year entirely by hand. But during the Great Depression, consumers couldn't spend as much as they used to on cigars. And so Tampa cigar factories adopted some hand-operated cigar machines that are now 90 years old to assist in that process by reducing some of the labor involved.
The mechanization completely changed the industry. So there were thousands of people who were out of work.
Beginning in the 1960s, the labor cost of manufacturing cigars by hand in the United States continued to increase. And so Tampa, which once had 200 cigar factories, started losing them. Factory owners moved their production overseas to Latin America, where labor is much cheaper. And now we're the last traditional cigar factory still rolling cigars in the country. There's a rich history of cigar making in our country that dates back to 1612. And we think that legacy of cigar making is important. It's important for the country's history, and it's important for the history of our community here in the cigar city of Tampa, Florida.
That's it for this edition of Matter of Fact. I'm Soledad O'Brien. I'll see you next week back in New York City.
To watch more stories like this anytime, head to matteroffact.tv.